putting on, putting on. Everywhere I go, I'm putting on. Putting on. What you want? Step under the court like 2-3. I was made for the game like Kyrie. Representing for the city, yeah, I be. In the land, is where you gon' find me. Courtside at the Q in the flow seat. Everybody in the team need green bills, y'all know it's the green season. Catch me only up a short scene. Ripping with the hot sauce like I'm street leaguing. And one though, on the flow going up though. 3 points to the dunk though. Me and Shove though. My city, my city. Been turned up on the jump though. Boy, I'm from the land till I die. Till I die, on the east side, till I die. Till I die, rocking that wine and gold, till I die. Till I die, in the hood, I'm good, till I die. CLE, till I die. Everywhere I go, I'm putting on. Putting on, putting on. Everywhere I go, I'm putting on. Putting on, putting on. Everywhere I go, I'm putting on. Putting on, putting on. Everywhere I go, I'm putting on. Putting on what you want.
We're live, the home of the Chicago Bulls, the United Center. Looking at Chicago, they want to turn
it. But at the end, you know, when it matters most in terms of what I call winning time, they just could not make the plays. On either end of the floor.
Yeah, I like that term, winning time. But as you said, they didn't get run over, but just couldn't convert when they needed to in the end.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. So for the Golden State Warriors right now, the Splash Brothers are the guards. The defensive stalwarts, Green and Bogut, are down low. And it's Rush in at the three spot.
Woo-hoo. Sweet move, tough finish. What a play.
What a year for the Warriors. Clark won their division for the first time in 39 years, ran away with the very tough Western Conference.
And there were a number of surprises last season, Kevin, but the Warriors were at the top of the list. I mean, I don't think anybody, including you and I, pegged them to be as good as they were.
Especially the way the finals began.
Exactly.
Stolen by Rose. Curry kicks to Thompson. Offline from the top of the key.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
And here we go with Curry running it up the court.
And the Warriors won 51 games back in 2014, improved that mark by 16 wins last season. Among teams that won at least 50 games in the previous year, that 16-game improvement was an NBA record for the Warriors.
Good on both.
It goes without saying the Warriors set franchise records all over the place with their play, their win total being the highest ever. But also of note, it was the first time they've won 50 games in back-to-back seasons. They seem to truly have arrived as a top-notch franchise in this current state of the NBA. Still scoreless after four attempts, trying to take the lid off the basket. They've been hot here early, dropping them in left and right.
Rolling, rolling, rolling. We'll see how long they can keep it going.
And Thompson kicks to Bogut. Curry with another miss.
Still looking for their first basket. Five misses to start the game.
Rose. Off target there. That would have pushed the lead to double digits.
Ending around that time and giving up the second chance opportunity.
You know, that just can't happen. They need much more effort than that on the glass.
They get the rebound. Here's Mirotić. Gasol dishes to Rose. Good, and the assist goes to Gasol. That's 7 points for Derrick Rose. They double-team Kerr. Bogut the pass to Kerr. Let's the three fly. The rebound by Gibson. Gibson's got three rebounds so far in the game.
He's going to play his way right onto the bench and out of the game if he continues to shoot it like he has so far in this quarter.
And he gets it to go.
And it doesn't really matter who starts the break with how he runs the floor. He seems to always be the one who finishes it.
Yeah, he is so fun to watch and how he attacks the rim at full speed like that, man. It's something to behold the way that guy gets to the rim.
Now here's Curry following the miss by Derrick Rose. Here's Thompson. Mirotić grabs the miss.
There was just enough defensive pressure to get him off balance and cause that shot to go awry.
For a franchise that had so much success under his tenure, there was sure a lot of friction with Tom Thibodeau, and the Bulls front office surprised a lot of people by only shooting himself.
Yeah, you know, it's not something that you see often. A winning coach at odds with his GM and president. With how often their differences came up, though, you knew something was afoot.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Portis, he's checked in for Gasol. Doug McDermott comes in for Mirotić. Kirk Heinrich, he's checked in for Jimmy Butler. And Brooks subbed in for Rose.
They ran that inbounds play perfectly there to get the quick hitter.
And with Thibs, he did end up getting fired from the Bulls this past season. Some saw it coming, but still, I think surprising given the level of success he had. His imprint is all over this Bulls team and the way they approach the game. Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
Rebounding is going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
It always is, and it has been so far, and they've gotten a nice edge on the glass.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they want.
The Warriors shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
And on the season, you know, they're hitting about 76%, which is a decent rate.
And this year, they haven't quite been able to maintain the free throw percentage they had last season.
Get back. Moving it up.
Oh, a monumental buzzer beater!
What a thrilling shot.
And we've reached the end of the first quarter. It's Chicago, leading by 9. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And guys, what's your take on the Bulls so far?
Just the way they've been able to pound that backboard. I think that's been the difference.
Establishment of a good low post presence, a big part of the success.
Gibson is the four with Gasol at the five. Rose is the one with Butler as the two. And it's Mirotić in the small forward position. That's the Bulls' five as we get into the second quarter. Here's Rose. Down through the hoop it goes. That's his fifth make on 9 shots from the floor.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's 4 straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point-blank range. Can't happen.
Gasol kicks to Rose. Outside Gibson. A second chance effort. And it's sent back by Spates. Here's Barbosa. That falls. Nice feed that time from Andre Iguodala.
That's a terrific sequence at both ends of the floor. They block the shot and recover it for the fast break finish.
And it's Rose penetrating. Rose with another miss. You can point to any number of things, Clark. The Warriors did well last year. Their play on the road being one of them.
Well, the Warriors were exactly road Warriors all season long, partner. Hit the ground running and finished with the league best 28 road wins.
Over to the left wing. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
And, Greg, you know, the defense has been very slow to adapt. I mean, that's 10 straight points now inside.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Bairstow, he's checked in for Gasol. Portis comes in for Taj Gibson. McDermott's checked in for Miritich. It's Heinrich in for Jimmy Butler. And timeout call. Steve Kerr has had enough.
Give him a hand. Come on, Chicago.
And for the Warriors, they would go on several road trips undefeated last season. Still, the only time they looked vulnerable were games on the road.
Curry kicks to Green. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
And, you know, with the Warriors on the road, they would occasionally dig a hole they couldn't get out of. Still, hard to critique a team that was so dominant in every facet of the game last season, even on the road.
And here in the second, 2 minutes gone by. Curry again throws. Out to the wing. McDermott. Rebounded by Bogut.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take.
Here's Curry, and it's good off the back of the rim and in. Curry's got his first 2 points.
Just impressed with the teamwork out there, setting the table for one another.
Five straight baskets, Greg, resulting from assists. They're playing as one unit out there. Well, they won't be down for long if they can get some more early offense just like that.
And, Clark, the best way to get that early offense is with steals. That allows you to get out in transition.
Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had early.
Chicago leading by four. Rose goes in, and Draymond Green picks up the foul. That's his first foul.
Man, it's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Yeah, and as quick as players are at this level, in this day and age, I mean, you've got to be perfect in your anticipation to draw the charge. Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And oh, hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Just piling on the lead with a dunk like that. And guys, one thing that we were treated with.
Oh! Tell you what, he's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Absolutely insane with that dunk.
Well, now they're starting to rub it in. Aren't they having filled up a lead? And here we go, folks. It's showtime.
That was a Kodak moment right there. The more plays they make like that, the more they'll have these guys on the ropes.
Here's Rose. Makes that one fall. It's his eighth bucket in 15 shot attempts.
And he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
And Bogut slams it in.
And, guys, this game won't be close for long if they keep giving up dunks like that.
No, it won't, G. You're right. A glaring error defensively and letting him get all the way to the basket that time.
But it's only 2 points. I mean, it was flashy, no doubt. But still, it only counts for two. Two is all. Great anticipation and awareness to come up with the steal and trigger the fast break.
And now just a one-possession game thanks to that quick hitter. Outstanding play in the open court.
And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
And injuries, once again, were a central theme of the Bulls' season last year. Losing Rose was one thing, but then having Jimmy Butler lose a lot of time put them in such a tough spot.
The Warriors making a switch here. Vasili's checked in for Bogut. Spates comes in for Green. Andre Iguodala, he's checked in for Brandon Rush. And it's Barbosa in for Steph Curry. Rose, no good.
You can see he just rushed that a little bit. Lost the focus, I think.
The Warriors have gone 4 of 6 so far from the line, missing a couple. So both teams changing it up here. And it's tied up with that one. 16 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Brooks outside. With one on the clock. So a tie game here as we finish the first half. And we'll be back right after halftime to get the third quarter underway. And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. A fantastic game from Derrick Rose in this one.
I just love the tenacity on the defensive side. I mean, his play on D has been a huge factor for them as he continues to get steal after steal.
And guys, as the game moves on, I think he should continue to be aggressive defensively to keep ball handlers off balance.
Welcome back, everyone. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. A fantastic game from Derrick Rose in this one.
The way he was able to attack the rim in that first half, defenders are going to need to start building walls and being connected defensively if they want to have any chance to stop him.
Now, come on, Greg. That's much easier said than done when he's the penetrator. I mean, his speed and agility make him extremely tough to cover.
So for the Golden State Warriors right now, it's the Splash Brothers, Curry and Thompson. They're in the backcourt. Green at the 4 with Bogut at the 5. And it's Rush in at the 3. Mirotić dishes to Gibson. It's stolen by Curry. And Thompson throws it down.
And guys, that's a big swing right there. I mean, taking the steal and then turning it into 2 easy points on the dunk.
No telling how important that sequence could turn out to be.
And guys, in a game this snug, moments like that are the ones we usually look back on at the end as a difference maker.
Now the Warriors moving it up. Wow, and that sort of showmanship is just deflating right now to a team trying Clark to get back into this game like this.
Yeah, definitely a jam with emphasis. A big apostrophe or exclamation point. How about maybe even a question mark, partner?
Yeah, I would have to say there are a lot of questions right now from a defensive standpoint. That's for sure.
So many great statistics are available to demonstrate just how dominant the Warriors were last season. My favorite is, GA, their point differential.
You know, to be able to beat your opponent by double digits on average is something only 8 teams have been able to do in the history of the league.
It's amazing. Now a timeout called by Golden State.
And guys, the Warriors ended the year at just over a 10-point differential per game. I mean, still that number is staggering when you think of what it takes to achieve that mark over the course of a season. Typically, championship teams are somewhere in the +6 to +8 range. 10 is off the charts.
Warriors leading by 4.
And you know what? That Warriors point differential was helped out a lot by their play at home. The home differential was almost plus 15 points per game. A lot of blowout wins. Scary thing is they set their starters in the fourth so often, they could have made those numbers even higher had they won it.
Bogut kicks to Thompson. Last break, here comes Chicago. Heinrich's got the ball. Portis, the best to Heinrich. Warriors with the rebound. Rush has got his third rebound on the night. Ball's knocked loose. It's stolen by Heinrich. Rush with the steal. Here's Thompson. Bogut dishes to Thompson. Battles through traffic and lays it in. Thompson's got the lead up to six now for the Warriors.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
Just no resistance on the interior. That's leadership. Really, really valuable to have someone who can just take charge like he has.
Well, there's a certain amount of confidence you have when the ball is in his hands at that end of the floor right now. I mean, he just gives you a sense of calm and confidence because of how good he is.
And the advantage they have starting to increase. Things are coming together for them at a really opportune time.
You know, they don't want to let them hang around too long here. I agree with you. I mean, it's best to go ahead and build that lead here in the third.
I tell you what, he has quite the act to follow. But Fred Hoiberg was a quick choice for the brass in Chicago. Signed that five-year deal over the summer. Was easily one of the most in-demand coaches available.
To the paint. Here's Portis. Nice D from Bogut. Left block shot on the way. And he gets it to go. Rush has got six in the quarter.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key.
It really has, Clark. The defense unable to react as quickly as necessary in terms of dealing with their passing.
So for the Bulls. Bairstow, he's checked in for Gasol. And it's Brooks in for Butler. Now here's McDermott. He's covered by Iguodala. Just five on the clock. Here's Heinrich. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Bulls made the postseason for the 10th time in their last 11 seasons last year. They have become a fixture, Greg, in the playoffs in the East.
And how about last season, Kevin, had that interdivision matchup in their first round against the up-and-coming Bucks. Some hiccups for them in that series, but they were able to prevail.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Finish off the break. Heinrich's got 6 points.
Tell you what, that was all made possible by the heads-up defense at the other end.
And I love that as soon as they get their hands on the basketball, they immediately get out and transition.
And Spates gets it to go.
Three consecutive baskets have come right at the rim. Defense had better start buckling down and tightening up.
Guys, they are getting exposed in terms of their low post defense.
Iguodala, that's a two-pointer. Off target with that shot. And that does it for the third quarter. Both teams clicking offensively as we approach the fourth quarter. Warriors lead by 8. From the United Center in Chicago, back in a moment. Well, welcome back as we get set to start the fourth. Warriors leading by 8. Gibson is the 4 with Gasol at the 5. Derrick Rose is out there with Brooks. And it's Mirotić in the 3 slot. So that's the 5 in the game for Chicago. Here's Chicago. Fast break. Here comes Chicago. And he gets it to go. And that's now 21 points for Derrick Rose.
You know, guys, one of the things that is always going to keep you competitive against the West is a good defense. It's one reason why the Bulls tend to be a tougher matchup for teams from the West, because they do D up.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Hi, Kevin. Steve Kerr was just going over the plan with his team. He told the Let's put our foot on them and keep them down. We've got them exactly where we want them. I want to see you guys slow the pace, use the clock, and stay away from any silly fouls.
And thank you, Doris. Jimmy Butler, he's checked in for Aaron Brooks. Bulls had a good year against the West last season, 17 up, 13 down against the Western Conference.
Yeah, and how about playing 500 or better against every division in the Western Conference? So impressive to think they did so well given how many games some of their starting players missed.
Outside Curry. Fires from deep. And yes, sir, that one drops. And the Warriors lead by 7.
That's just run of the mill for him. A typical day at the office. He's one of the more skilled offensive players out there.
And the basket by Rose.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make 5 in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too. Even against solid defense, he's still going to try to continue to make that shot.
And I wouldn't bet against him in that situation the next time out.
Pedal to the metal right now, really pushing.
And 3 of their last 5 makes here, coming in transition.
Some changes for Golden State. Bogut comes in for Festus Ezeli. And it's Thompson in for Leandro Barbosa.
Wow, that's a really smooth finish.
That's why we and they always love seeing him at the end of those breaks. He makes it look fun and easy.
The shot misses. And in Chicago the other way. Here we go, one-on-one. Oh, and the jam by Butler.
Rising high to throw that one down.
Sky high, fantastic one-hand jam.
Nice, nice way there, guys, to finish up that possession.
Took him no time at all on that one. And that's now 11 points for Steph Curry. Rose gets to Gasol. It's good. This time the assist from Rose. Rose has got his 4th assist with that last one here tonight. Here's Green. Scored the bucket. He's made 5 so far, shooting a very clean 5 of 7.
And the deeper we get into this game, it seems like the more the offenses are in rhythm.
Without question, I mean, both of these teams are firing on full broadband bandwidth. The full throttle ahead.
And what a gutty play. I mean, muscles his way to the rebound and then just pounds it home for the putback.
Well said, GA. The battle on the boards, Clark, could go a long way toward deciding this game.
You know, and if that play is any indication, that's a battle they're willing to put every ounce of their energy into winning.
Rose passes to Gasol. And Steph Curry with the foul. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game. McDermott's checked in for Miritich. And we're about 3.5 minutes into the 4th quarter. And Butler gets it to go.
That's what they're hanging their hat on today, fellas. Hard-nosed, smash-mouth play down on the low block.
Old-fashioned, isn't it, my man? Old-fashioned. Pound the rock basketball, and it is definitely working for them.
In transition, here come the Bulls. Rose has got the ball. And Butler, here we go. And he overdid it there. Too much force, it looked like, on the foul, and he's called for the flagrant.
And Kevin, I got to tell you, he's probably fortunate to just get a flagrant 1 there. I mean, so much contact. The officials easily could have gone even harder on it.
Greg, I agree. He better be on his best behavior from now on. 1 more flagrant of any variety, and he's out of here.
And you really can't say enough about his composure in the big moments, as cool as they come.
Rose goes in, and it's sent back by Bogut. Here's Curry. Cannot hit. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. They've led by as many as 11 points. Good!
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
It's good! A tremendous 3 to tie it up.
They don't get any bigger than that basket.
They needed it, Greg, and he gave it to them.
Rose dishes to Gasol. It's stolen by Bogut. And here we go. Thompson heading to the hoop.
And he placed that pass out in front of him and let him just run into it in rhythm.
Rose gets to Gasol.
Yes!
It really does make the game easy for your teammates when you can lead them to the rim that well with a pass.
Pass to Iguodala. 6 second difference between shot and game clock. Here's Bogut.
Count it!
You know, they got a foul to give here if they need it.
Yeah, definitely something to keep in mind for them right now.
Thompson passes to Green. Gasol with the steal. Butler goes in.
Money!
And Kevin, maybe the play of the game right there.
A tremendous instinct spray to come up with a steal and then attack the basket.
Game changer right there, guys. An unbelievable play to make it this stage of a really tight ball game.
Timeout called for Warriors. The score is tied at 63. 3 seconds left in the fourth. And that's out of bounds. Golden State will retain possession.
Yeah, that's a super defensive play. If that gets through, no doubt they score.
And that's why he sold out for it, because he knew he had to make that play. He wasn't going to let them get the advantage.
Yeah, that's what we call good defense in the paint, worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is, and maybe even more than that. I mean, you saw it right there. Without his presence, that's an easy battle.
Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over. It's stolen by Bogut. Regulation is ended, and we're heading to overtime. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And what great competition we're seeing so far. After regulation, the stalemate. And we'll see now how these two teams and these few minutes of basketball pan out. And it's the Warriors to start out. And always a good ride in these post-regulation battles. This overtime now looking to be an exciting one. Courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineup for us now in overtime. So for the Golden State Warriors right now, on the wing, Thompson and Iguodala. Azealia is out there with Bogut, and it's Curry in the point guard position.
Not an A-plus trip to the line, but he did get them the lead.
I mean, he was great in his last game, Clark, and clearly he has not lost that love and feel.
Solid on the one-hand throw down there.
You know, Clark, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Yep.
Yeah, and one reason why, I just don't know that I've ever seen him miss a play like that. That's the kind of D that you're not going to find success with, guys. They've got to get a hand in the face.
Here's Bogut. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Bogut's got the game tied up here for the Warriors.
Yeah, beautiful play on the interior. They're just using the height advantage to lay the ball up and in when they really needed that basket.
How about that fantastic finish and the aggressive move, too, Kevin?
Trying to send a message, Clark, with that slam, I think.
And I'm not sure if it was text or email, but he definitely threw that one down.
And the shot is good. Bogut's got 4 points this quarter.
Now, that's how you pick up second chance points. Stay active and be ready as soon as the shot goes up.
Shot's good from Butler.
You know, of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is major smash mouth basketball, guys.
And all about imposing your will offensively, getting exactly the kind of looks the coach drew.
Azili dishes to Thompson. And Brooks, here we go. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and 2 shots coming up.
Yeah, easy call.
Yeah, you could hear the smack all the way over here where we are.
And the Warriors making a change here. Green's checked in. So he gets them both in a four-point ball game.
And thanks to his good work at the line there, now we have a two-possession ball game.
Got that one up quick. 17 points for Steph Curry.
He's such a clutch shooter, Kevin. He just lives for the big shot.
Brooks. And it's sent back by Bogut. And so the ball out of bounds. Bogut touched it last. Derrick Rose is checked in for Chicago. Here's Butler. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. That one on Thompson.
All the officials are all over that.
Clearly a foul. I mean, didn't give him any choice but to blow the whistle. I mean, you got to play without fouling.
So he goes two for two at the line. And it's a three-point game.
And that was huge right there. Just as cool as he could be. And he's been clutch at the line there in a very tense moment.
Fires the three. It's in! And, oh, that was an enormous three-pointer.
A little bit of a defensive breakdown there. He's not the guy you want to leave open on the perimeter. You've got to stay attached to him.
Rose gets to Gasol. Tries again. Nails it!
They have got to put a body on him, because otherwise, with his agility and athleticism, they're not going to be able to contain him on the offensive line.
It's Curry outside. Does not find the basket. He's shooting 50% from the floor on 14 tries. Rose goes in. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
And they had a foul to give, but you want to use it on the ground.
Yeah, I agree with you there, but at least they did get the clock stopped. That is the one saving grace of that situation. Overtime has become do or die time. An empty possession here, and I think they're finished.
Outside for Curry. The three won't fall. Yes!
And with that basket, you'd have to think this lead is secure.
I'm almost ready to go there with you, partner. Not quite. I'm hanging around at that 98% mark, so it's just about done, but I need a little more evidence to close the book on.
There's the triple. The shot is off. And so it's Chicago winning this one. They escaped with a victory, although they needed, Clark, an extra period to get it done.
Well, I think it was one heck of a ball game. Both teams gave great effort, and the bounces just went their way in overtime.
And that about wraps it up. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching. And now we'll head over to the studio with Ernie Johnson.
Yeah.